Hi everyone, this is Christian here on YouTube and welcome to this brand new video for the channel. In today's video, I'm going to explain you what is overtrading and I'm going to tell you in three different features how you can identify if you are overtrading, which is one of the biggest mistakes of day trading, whether it's Forex, stock trading, or whatever is it that you're trading with. This is one of the biggest mistakes, overtrading. And this is basically what takes you to blow up your account in no time and feel frustrated all the time because you're not moving forward. So if you want to learn this, make sure you stay up until the end of this video. My name is Christian and this is the BLW Online Trading channel, and in this YouTube channel I do a lot of software reviews, broker reviews, and just like this one I give you tips and strategies as to how to make money with online trading. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. That being said, let's jump into the video. Hey, before I actually jump into this video, just want to give you a warm invitation to my BLW Trading Academy that you can take. The link is blwtradingacademy.com, and is where I teach you everything from zero as to how to start day trading. So you should definitely consider taking that training. There is a free training even that I give you beforehand so that you can learn what is it that you're going to learn inside of the training, just to give you like the first guidance into day trading. So you should definitely consider it. So the invitation is right there. Now let's jump into the video. So overtrading is one of the biggest mistakes that you can do when you are actually starting on day trading. And you hear this question in all of guru videos from Forex traders telling you, hey, don't overtrade. And I'm here to explain you what is overtrading in three different features. If you are making any of these three mistakes or these three activities, that means that you're overtrading and that's what you should avoid. Okay, so we're going to start with the first one, and the first one is placing many trades on the same prediction. So let's say that you analyze the market or you're following a prediction from a signal provider or something, but you entered the trade, right? It was a sell option and then you enter. And then you realize that the prices starts to jump a little bit more and you're like, oh, this is a better entry point, and you enter again. And it jumps a lot more and you're like, whoa, this will be a way better entry point. So you enter again and suddenly you have three sell positions on the same trade. What happens if that trade continues to go up? You're gonna not lose one trade, you're gonna lose three trades in one prediction. So if you are following a prediction, either is yourself or someone else's prediction, then what you should do is just place one trade and that's it. Even if you enter at the wrong entry point, you don't need to necessarily enter another trade if you don't do your own analysis. For instance, I enter sometimes two trades on the same pair, but I actually enter at two different entry levels, one lower and one with the next resistance level, and then I enter, but I'm 100% sure that the price will continue dropping, right? But that's when I'm doing my own analysis. But if you're not doing your own analysis, or if you think that the pair is going against your analysis and you keep on entering the trade, that's when you're overtrading. So if you're making that mistake, stop it now. Mistake number two is actually placing trades on all pairs. And I've seen this done by many day traders in the world, but mostly beginners, is when you see, okay, you start with Euro USD, then GBP USD, then USD CHF, then USD JPY, then you, and you place a trade on all of them. Why? You need to find a pattern that tells you what pairs to actually enter based on your own analysis, right? You do your fundamental analysis, then you do your technical analysis, and if it doesn't meet the requirements of the strategy that you're using, then you shouldn't enter that trade. There's no reason why you should enter the trade. There are weeks when I enter two trades, and there are weeks when I enter 10 trades. So it really depends on what is it that you're actually following. If you're looking for a retracement strategy like the one that I use most of the times, then you just wait for that specific retracement to actually happen so that you can enter the trade. But if you don't see it happening, there's no reason why you should enter the trade, okay? Even if you're placing the pending order and you think like, yeah, this level is not gonna be reached, but I'm still gonna place the pending order to see what happens. And then boom, during the week, there's a breakout and a change of trending and your trade starts to generate losses for you or hit the stop loss or whatever. So no, you don't need to place the trades on all pairs. If you're placing trades on all pairs just because you think that it will generate more money, then you're over trading. So if you're making this mistake, again, stop now, okay? Mistake number three that identifies that you're actually over trading is closing and reopening trades on the same pair. And this also happens all the time. Now, you enter a sell position and then you realize that it starts to jump. So you close in loss on the position that you open and you open a new one for a sell as well. That's over trading. You don't need to do that, okay? First, you already lost money. You shouldn't lose money, right? You should have a trading plan for that specific trade that will give you a stop loss level. And if that level is reached, that's it. It should be in your plan. But if you close the trading loss and you open a new one at a higher or a lower level, depending on what direction you're trading with, then you're over trading. That's a huge mistake. Or worse, and this is worse, when you actually close the trade on the opposite direction and you open it going to the opposite, like you buy a sell option but then you start jumping and then you close the sell option and you purchase a buy option, that's over trading. Okay, that means that you're not doing the analysis. Now, all of these mistakes usually happens when you are not having the correct weekly trading plan for you. I recommend you to watch my video where I actually explain what's my weekly trading plan, so that you understand what is the analysis that I do before I actually place any of those trades. I'm even prepared for all of the trades to be a loss. Why? Because it's part of the plan. It's part of the possibility. So I'm actually getting ready for it. But if you actually make the mistake of not having a trading plan, that's when you make any of these three mistakes. So if you're making any of these three mistakes, that means that you are over trading. So I hope you understand this explanation about what is over trading. And if you're doing over trading, don't be embarrassed and put it in the comment section below and let other people know what mistakes of these three you are doing. So if you found value in this video, if you found it helpful, make sure you smash the like button. And if you want to see more videos just like this one, make sure you are subscribed to this YouTube channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.